Blazing Hit Radio.
I love that morning show.
Now with more us.
They wake me up.
Better music, less commercials, more Larry and Kathie.
In the morning, in the shower.
And it's Friday.
Yeah.
Yay, Friday.
Thank God. And Kathy's here early. Everybody's here. It's Friday.
All right.
Thank you, Producer Bolt.
Yes.
So
you calling him Bolt or
Producer
Bolty?
Producer Bolty. I can't there's stick nicknames. With one name with him, man.
Yeah,
I call him Mike.
Yeah, Mikey. I call him Mike.
I call him Bolty, Producer Bolt.
Yeah.
Just not late to dinner.
There's a new survey. I want to get it going early this morning.
Oh, okay.
Okay, to ask people what they think.
Okay.
It has to do with work.
Okay.
Dating at work and swearing at work.
Okay, I do both.
Yeah, yes. And wait, there's only Bolty here. Who are you dating?
Well, it's none of your business. Wow. How do you think you got the job?
Really?
The same way Wiggins did.
Really?
Can I get an air horn?
No, don't give him an air horn. Oh, he gave you an air horn.
I just love air horn.
Okay. Yeah, you better say that.
Have you ever seen Bolty's in air horn?
No, have you?
It's pretty decent. Now he knows I'm lying because he says it's small.
All right, an air horn for the small one.
He says he's got baby junk.
That's just a joke.
I think, but that's to lower expectations. I think
absolutely.
That's smart.
I think that's like how Howard Stern says it.
I grew up with my brother being real cocky about it, so yeah. I've kind of toned it down.
So you go the other way.
Yeah.
So clearly his brother's hung and he's not. What does Stern say?
His brother got all of it.
Right. Wait, his brother got all the meat and he got all the taters.
Yeah, I'm all tater. Yeah.
That's really attractive.
He's right. Vegan not, junk.
But Howard Stern always says that all he like, has like a small
baby.
One.
Right.
But it's like, you're really tall. How could that be? You know,
it can happen.
It can happen, right?
Shaq is supposed to have like average length.
And there's no way.
Yeah, I know, right?
Although that would explain how Shawnee could have hung in there like
yeah,
she did.
Yeah, survived.
Right.
Because it was all just weight.
Yeah.
But I love how he's like, I'll do commercial for anybody.
Yeah.
Go to the general and save some time.
Yeah, he does.
Okay.
He's like the Isohot pack.
Yeah, that's right. He has that. I was going to say, what's the other one he has?
It's and then he's now on the Ring. He endorses the Ring.
He does?
Alarm system. Yep. He's there. He's all, hey, I can see myself in the mirror. <And you're> like,
life's just good for Shaq.
Yeah, for
yeah,
sure.
Right. So this is about people swearing at work and dating. Which one do you want to do first?
Swearing.
Okay. So how do you guys feel about people swearing at work?
Listen, when people are passionate and, you know, I don't know. I mean, like, I'm not a big fan of people who yell at people at work. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like bosses that go off or like I worked with the guy who like threw stuff and kicked stuff.
Oh, yeah. That's rad.
Yeah. I think that's a little weird.
Right.
But cursing in a funny way, like, I guess would be okay. But then now you're talking to HR. Who's all sensitive now?
Right.
You know?
True.
Right.
Do you care if people swear, Bolty?
Well, I've learned I can't get away with it anymore because we're on the radio and we right. need to tone it down.
Right.
No, your yeah. mind makes a click in your head because, you know, we're not comply with FCC laws. We could cuss if we wanted. Mm-hmm. We've let a couple things slip, but our intention is to not cuss.
Right.
So that the kids can still enjoy it on the way to school.
Right,
exactly.
For sure.
I remember when Larry set me up one morning. You didn't set me up, but we were talking about a fight that I'd gotten in with a girl or something.
Mm-hmm.
And you were like, and how'd that make you feel? And I was like, I wanted to kick the blank out of her, but right. I said it, and you looked at me like, ugh!
Right.
And I was like, and then I went even further. Oh, no, was I not supposed to say that?
Right.
Oh, God.
Right, instead of
and
like,
you draw more attention
right.
to it
uh-huh.
instead
of
just
like,
going over it.
Right, for sure.
Yeah, there was
when
that.
The FCC's involved, you kind of just keep moving like it didn't happen. Because, yeah, if the more you're like, oh, my God, I can't believe it happened, then people are like, huh, it
they look
happened.
Back. Yeah.
Right.
What was the bad one? It was a call with your mom.
Hmm.
And somebody was in editing it. It wasn't Kendall. And somebody was in there, and we did a call with your mom or something, and you were swearing about something on the call, and like an MF went out.
Right.
And then something else went out. And yeah. I remember we were like...
Statue of limitations.
Yeah, right. Oh, yeah. Total statue of limitations. Because this was the old building, like the old,
right.
old building
right.
on Monaco.
Right.
But 4 out of 10 people... say it's never okay. So, you know, more than half are saying, yeah, it happens.
Right.
Which is good news for most of us.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hell isn't a swear word, is it?
Well, I mean, it kind
not
of
anymore.
Is.
Yeah, not yeah. anymore.
Well, no, I just read this whole article about how, like, everybody's lightening up on the S word.
Mm.
So now, like, you'll hear that word in late night TV shows and stuff like that.
And the president.
Right, right. Oh, yeah. right, for sure.
Six out of 10 people say that, you know, it happens if you swear at work. 36% of people say it's okay in certain circumstances, but not all the time.
Like if you're in construction and you saw part of your finger off.
Oh,
go
well,
for it.
Everyone's swearing.
Let it go.
Everyone's swearing. And one out of 10 people say, you know what? Blanket. Let the swear words fly all day, every day.
Those are like people that work on, you know, the Broncos.
And their bad little kids are running around
exactly.
the DMV.
Have right. little babies kids running around. All right. Now, when it comes to dating, did you ever date anyone that you worked with, Bolte?
Yeah, I tried that. It's the worst. Don't do that. What is that crap where you eat?
Yeah, don't crap. Don't.
Blank where you blank.
Yeah, blank right. where you.
Right, so right. we don't cuss here.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Don't blank where you blank. I've done it.
No,
I did
don't
it a
blank
lot.
Where you eat. Right.
Yes. According to a new survey, the new corporate strategy for office romance is the following. You can ask a coworker out once. If they say no, you better stop. Because if you ask him out more than that, you're now falling into the hashtag Me Too sexual harassment movement.
Right there. Mm-hmm. Man, everybody's like, it's going to eventually be like, the good old days when you used to be able to screw the boss and come in and be like, woohoo.
Pinch a butt.
Right, exactly.
And I
your
literally,
boobs look good today.
Right. And I literally did that, you know, for like a while. I was like dating the married boss. Remember?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so, yes, there was, you asked Bolte, have you ever dated a coworker? Well, breezed right past me.
Well, yeah, he has a good
next.
One.
I wanted to get, no, Larry does.
No, he was actually a really good one.
He dated a married coworker.
Yeah, that was weird. I didn't mean to get caught up in that, but it was just like, what can you do?
Did you get favoritism by being, I mean, you're already on the morning show. So
sometimes,
already...
like, man, I think back at that, and it was crazy. Like, I was like, he was going to conferences and stuff, and I was like hanging in his hotel the
what?
Whole time.
Yeah. Say what?
Yeah, that was awesome.
You're getting the inside scoop.
Yeah, no, for sure. And I definitely, like, I never try to, like, work it to my advantage. Like, hey, I should get favor. But, I mean, I think that there was probably a couple instances where he looked the other way on some stuff, I guess.
Oh, right.
But it was nothing major, you know?
Okay.
But, yeah, he's, like, hot. Super hot.
And he's the boss. That makes it even hotter.
He was like, hot, but to me, he was little.
I know, but...
He was a little guy. I'm not into little guys.
He was shorter than me, but the thing is, like, there was nothing little about
him. Okay.
At all.
Oh, yeah, I do remember you saying that.
Yeah, it was,
that.
Like, epic.
Okay.
Like, epic.
There had to be something to keep you coming
back.
Right.
Like a tripod.
Right.
So, the survey is saying out there, everybody... If the person doesn't even have to say no, a lawyer for Facebook says that ambiguous answers to will you go out with me? If the person responds with I'm busy or I can't, mm-hmm. that counts as the no.
Okay.
So don't ever go back to that well.
Oh, okay. Yeah. But sometimes it's just it's like chemistry. You know what I mean? It's like passing each other in a tight spot where you're going to be like, something's there. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We don't even have to speak.
That's what drives you. It makes it more fun. You're kind of being secretive and
yeah, no, there is
sneaky.
That.
That's funny that you bring that up because I was thinking the other day about how, like, they say this young generation, they have no care if somebody's gay or not, doesn't even register.
Right.
So I was thinking, like, for me, part of the allure, I guess, of being gay has been, I was told my whole life, like, that's wrong. You can't do that.
Okay.
So I feel like to a certain degree, I'm like, ooh, I'm being naughty.
Oh, yeah, you know what I mean? I'm wrong.
Right.
I'm
exactly.
So bad.
And that's kind of like what is appealing about it, I guess. So I'm thinking that generations from now, there's no not taboo
there's no
about
not
it.
Naughty, right.
Right. So I don't know if it's going to have the same effect on them. They're just going to be like boring gay couples. They're not going to have sex or anything.
Will
like,
they even be sexual?
Right. Let's just hold hands in the park in our non-gender neutral situation.
Mm-hmm. What was that movie with Sylvester Stallone and he went
to the future?
Sandra Bullock was there.
Yeah, for sure.
And Demolition Man.
Yeah.
Right?
I think
and
so.
their way of having sex was just virtual reality.
Right.
So they'd sit next to each other and put the goggles on, and that's how they have sex.
Right.
Which you never know what's going to happen. They say everybody's going to have a sex robot by 2050.
I want one.
Yeah, and I hope they look way realer than the ones that are out now. Those are creepy.
Yeah, they are creepy.
But it's going to be even creepier if it looks real, because then you're going to be like,
And think of the population and the fact that nobody's going to be going out anymore, so nobody will be giving eye contact or even know how to talk to each other. It's going to be a weird world.
Right, and then everybody's going to be like, you're going to walk in and see somebody's robot and go, I know what you guys were doing.
Yeah. Right.
It like, stinks. Oh,
yeah. Right. It smells like burnt rubber.
Okay.
And electronic wires.
Let us know.
And sex.
If you dated the coworker, how it worked out for you, and if somebody in your office swears too much.
Yeah, you can hit us up on the YOLO Rum line, 303-728-3420. We've never started a topic this early.
No.
But we want you to get involved. 303, it's Open Phone Friday, 728-3420. You can call us about anything, but we really want you to hit us up if you've ever, you know, dipped your pen in company ink.
Right.
Blazing Hit Radio.
I love that morning show.
Now with more us.
They wake me up.
Better music, less commercials, more Larry and Kathy.
In the morning, in the shower.
I were already getting a big response on people that have hooked up with people at work. And, you know, I had said earlier that I had hooked up with a guy that was a former boss. And it's kind of like one of those dumb things where you're like, you think people don't know. But then, you know, everybody could tell because, you know, we were at the radio station on Orchard, and there was a couple in there that all the time we were like, you could just tell by the way people act, you know?
Yeah.
Producer Bolt, like, you know how we act. You're around other people. Yeah, we're like, I'm going to get you. Mm-hmm. Stop it.
Tickle fight.
But no, for real though, you can. Kathy's upstairs, by the way, doing her wig. How rude. She's getting her show prep as well. But no. As far as the work thing, you know, like, you sometimes you're so euphoric about being in something new, you don't care what people think.
Mm-hmm.
But some people are really good at hiding it. Like, I like one of those couples, you find out somebody's a couple at work and you're like, you guys have been dating? That's really weird. This Gerardo says, he texts us in, 25 years ago, married 21 years, have 4 daughters, now I can't get rid of her.
You're so stuck, bud.
Right? So some people actually meet their spouse at work.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? By the way, it's very foggy outside, and, oh, wow. Sorry, that's Kathy blowing her nose. Can you shut the bathroom door, please? Seriously, that's what she sounds like when she blows her nose? But it is super foggy out there, especially on I-70. It was like kind of weird visibility, so be careful out there, everybody. And continue to hit us up if you ever dipped your pen in company ink, 303-728-3420. You can also send us a shout-out on the app, hit the menu bar, and just record a shout-out and hit us up. We also posted this on our Facebook page.
Call or text us now.
I'm so excited.
On the YOLO Rum phone line.
Alexa, will you be my friend?
Of course we can be friends.
303-728-3420.
You seem very nice.
That Drake song gives me all the feels, like, in the sense that I love Drake.
Yeah.
And I can't. He went away for a second.
Yeah.
Which is fine because
he needed to.
He did too. So did Rihanna.
Yes.
Everybody needs to go away and put on the freshman 40.
Let us miss you.
Right. For sure. But right. Then, you know, it's hit or miss because then you really are on a comeback every time you take a break.
You are.
And it's like sometimes it's not guaranteed.
Eminem.
Hashtag Katy Perry.
Oh, Katy Perry.
And Eminem.
I know.
As far as sales go, is what they're, you know, levels are used to.
Even though
to.
People love what they put out again.
Right, like their you fan love base. Right.
Swish, swish, bish. You and love
the
one that.
In the basket. Oh, here's why I'm really sad about that song.
Why?
And it just really makes me bummed out. Is because that was a total in Taylor Swift's face.
Yes.
And it really needed to be a big hit. And so, because that's what the whole thing is. Like, Bitch, I just got another hit in your face. And then Nicki Minaj comes out, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, totally.
Right. And so it wasn't a monster hit. And
it
then
wasn't.
Nobody liked the one with all the food, Bon Appetit, baby.
Oh, yeah.
And
you
Migos.
Liked that one, too.
That's a great record. So here's the thing.
Right.
It's like if an artist is off or, like, the heat's not on them, it's sad because if you really, like, go back and if you're a core fan of that person, you're the one that can really judge the quality of their work.
Yeah.
And that was those all should have been hits off there. And the Missy Elliott, her first single back should have been a hit.
No, I loved Missy Elliott's first single song, back.
Right. And, you know, and even I will even go as far as to say Janet Jackson, she's had a couple singles that would have been normal monster Janet hits, but she, you know, it's
like what?
No, so it's off her last album. Guy, don't make me try to sing.
Oh wait,
it.
we played or we tried to.
It's Burn It Up.
Okay.
I know it's
the name of it's called Burn It Up.
Janet Jackson, Burn It Up.
Okay.
But it's like if you hear it, it has everything that it would take to have a Janet hit,
as in a cool beat.
Everything.
The things like, she's saying is cool.
Right. And if you go online, like, there's these choreography groups that do dances to those songs.
Uh-huh.
There's a crew in London that like their video has more hits than her actual video.
So she needs to do what Beyonce did. Remember when Beyonce went and got the twins?
Yeah.
Those two dudes?
Yeah, for sure.
And was like, what are you dancing? How are you doing that? Right. Teach me this.
For sure.
Right. And now Janet needs to do that too. She still can.
Yeah, I know. But I mean, it's for people like her, Mariah, and all those others, it's harder to come back.
It is.
Because everybody else is 12 now on the charts.
Right. Is that Missy? Miss
Jackson, yeah. She with a crown. Brand new sound, got a brand new style. Coming with the banger like boom, boom, pow, wow. Ooh, 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 child.
Janet Jackson, come soon to your town. I ain't never gonna go nowhere. Yeah, that's a good song. Quick to brand new, you know I've been right here. Lately I've been known on a mission, yeah. But that I mean, I've forgotten how to move you, yeah. Yeah, so tell me what you wanna do. Don't do nothing stupid. What is happening in front of you? All it is love on the booth. Let's go! When the DJ play this, we gon' feel like no one's watching. Hey, Mr. DJ, keep the track and won't you turn. Okay, I got to see the dance video of the guys in London.
Yeah, oh my God, they kill it.
It's such a good beat. I bet you could do some cool dancing to it.
No, and they're like, they kill it. You're like, whoa, I guess British people can dance too.
Yes. You know who just recently went to one of her concerts and he posted like 10 different clips of her singing and blah, blah, blah. Samuel Jackson.
Oh, wow.
And like he got to be in the sound booth.
The right. Soundboard. He's the oldest brother.
Yeah.
It goes Samuel, Tito, Jermaine. Jackie. Right, not a lot of people know that.
No, but not a lot of people know. He's
the darkest Jackson.
He's the OG.
Darkness.
Well, I'm glad he didn't get suckered into the nose job. The rest of them had. Because I like Samuel Jackson the way he looks.
Say Jackson again. Say it again. Say Neverland again. I dare you.
I dare you. I double dare you.
we got some response on the text line. It's Open Phone Friday.
Yeah.
So we really want to push you guys to interact with us and call us right now at 303-728-3420. We get a ton of text. We don't know why you're so shy that you can't call.
Right.
But we love that you're texting, but definitely hit us up. That's why we have the phone line. Justify our cost.
Yeah.
Kathy and I literally paid for the phone line.
We literally
did. Out of pocket.
So please, if you could, let us know.
We just want to know if it works. 303-728-3420. That's a YOLO Rum line.
Yes.
And so hit us up. But we did get some texts.
Yeah. So we were talking about coworkers.
And I was talking about yesterday how I hooked up with my boss. And it was awesome because
Just a minute ago you were talking
about. I mean, like, I mentioned it like to you on this
when we
talked about this coming up. And I was like, oh my gosh, sometimes when you're like all whooped for somebody and you're all like in it, you don't think anybody else can tell that you're a couple.
Oh,
but then everybody at work's like, you know, because it's like, oh, look, they go off and laugh by themselves.
Right.
So they always ride together.
Yeah.
Right. Because we spotted a couple in our last office. We were like,
man, it was way too obvious. And they were both married, Bolte.
And
I mean, definitely she was hot. I mean, they were both hot.
No, he was hot.
Yeah, and he was hot for sure.
And I remember we'd watch them like go see each other because they worked on opposite sides of the building. And one time, as a joke, I called his number.
You would.
I called him.
Wait for this.
And he goes, hello. And I go, meet me in the garage. I said it in a girl's voice. I go, meet me in the garage. And then I hung up.
Right.
And then
we all went down to the garage.
Right, to see if they were going to go meet up or if he would like take the bait.
And he did.
Yeah.
You're right.
So we saw him walking around. We're all, hey, what's going on? So
we acted like we were coming in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they were like finding little places to meet up. But that's what happens when you date somebody at work.
But then he made it so obvious. You remember near the end? Like, so her she was sales. So she was down closer to the GM, right?
And she had the dopest boyfriend. Like, he was so hot.
He was super cool swag.
Like, way hotter than the guy she was cheating with.
Yeah, right.
Right. So that
her man was so cool.
Right. That makes me think that the only reason it was happening is because that other guy, was probably like hung.
He's given raises. That's why.
No. They weren't in the same department.
The guy at our work was hung.
Right. Was probably hung. Totally. Because that guy was like had everything going for him. So I don't know.
Or you know the guy that we worked with though he had swagger. Like
he had
a cool vibe.
He was cocky.
He was cocky for sure. But anyways,
cocky.
There was like an outdoor balcony thing that no one ever went out on. That was right near where her office or her cubicle was.
Right.
And one day he literally went out there to wait for her. So it was like, you're going to notice a person standing outside the building, you know, when you're walking by. They towards the end, they got sloppy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, real sloppy. We saw her like leaning over like the balcony. Uh-huh. And we're like, man, she's really been leaning there for a long time. And then he stood up behind her.
Oh, yes.
So we're like, I know what he had for lunch.
Oh, yes. Shut up. So on the text line, you guys have this to say. I've never dated at work, but I always have work husbands.
Oh, yeah.
Shoot. Sometimes I even have a work wife. Totally. Yeah,
that's true because work spouses are a little different. I mean, it's probably dangerous if you're both attracted to each other.
Yes.
But if you're not, it's cool to have a...
Like, work husband or work wife.
Right. Wiggs has always been my work wife.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I'm your work wife.
Oh, that's right. I mean, dork. You're my work wife in the sense of we're getting work done, but Wig and I are the work wife of like, where do you want to go to lunch?
Yeah, that's true.
Right.
They're fighting. They're on. Baby they're talk. Off again.
Right.
Yeah. Although I guess I'm more your work sister.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we don't go there.
The jokes you,
Kathie and I have only had sex.
You throw at me.
Yeah, Kathie and I have only gone there, what, three times?
Yeah. Well, I don't. I wouldn't count
enough to make Avery.
You're drunk.
Oh, yes. Enough to make Avery. Don't say that. People already think that you're her dad.
Yeah, that is awesome. I mean, because, you know, I'm gay. I never thought anybody would think I had a kid.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Somebody did think I had a kid once.
They did?
Yes. And this is, remember? Okay, this is so funny because... When I look back at pictures of when Wiggins started with us,
okay,
I'm blown away by how young he looked.
Totally.
Like when he took that picture with Will Smith, I'm like, you look like you've never shaved. Right. And so all of a sudden I was driving with Wig and some listener pulled up and they're like, hey, Larry. And I was like, hey, what's going on? And he's like, is that your son? And we just busted up laughing. I just called, hey, come on, son.
Yeah, I remember that.
This is Wiggins.
You guys should dress alike.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so this is a long one on the text line. I was dating my boss, worked with him for a year, thought things were great until he brought his pregnant wife to the staff Christmas party. Everyone we worked with knew we were dating, but they also knew he was married with a kid on the way.
Whoa.
And they didn't say anything to me.
Whoa. So he never even said anything to her.
Mm-mm. I'd been to his house before and never saw any pictures of him with his wife. He would stay at my house several nights a week.
Whoa.
I had no idea. I stopped talking to him after, and he acted like I was the one being unreasonable for not wanting to keep our relationship going after I found out about his wife and his pregnant or his soon-to-be child.
Wow.
I left the job a couple months later for a better opportunity and what I've heard is he finally divorced her and recently contracted herpes.
Karma is a bitch.
Got him.
Wow. Yeah, right? Oh. So wait a minute. That's crazy because when your wife's pregnant, you really have to be around to help. And
so not being there 3 days a week?
Right.
Where is she thinking he was?
Exactly.
You're not that busy at work.
Right.
Unless you're a CEO.
Or you're just a good liar.
And then I have a great life and you're cheating. Fine.
Right. Or he's just a good liar and he's like, another project.
See, that's crazy.
Right.
That's crazy. Or I have early morning meetings.
Right. So I better just stay closer to the work or whatever.
Yeah, I see that. On the text line, good morning, guys. All my past girlfriends, lovers, wives have been from a work relationship. Wow.
Whoa.
In hindsight, I think some of my past decisions could have been better if I got out of the work box. Several relationships later, I've been married almost 10 years with my wife that I met at a job. Wait, is that it? Yeah, that I met at that job at the time.
So he's like hindsight. That means he was checking out her ass.
Yeah.
We've known a lot of people that met at work, including you and Mr. Fishett.
I was going to say Mr. Fishett and I met at work. But the thing was, I don't think that people caught on to it because prior to us dating, we were all friends in a group.
Right. No, that's not why people didn't. That's why not people didn't catch on. That's not why it was.
Why?
Because he was white. And so everybody was like, well, if she was dating any guy here, it'd be one of the black guys.
Exactly, right. Right. She'd be over at the fan.
Right, clearly she's helping JJ do some stuff.
Right.
She's like, how sweet of her.
Right.
Right.
And that's usually how it was, because it was nothing new for any of us to be hanging out together.
Right.
Aldo and JJ, I'd go hang out with JJ. Yeah, so.
Nobody knew you guys were doing the nest.
Nobody knew.
Oh, wait.
Yeah.
And then one day we finally had to tell you.
Right.
We were like, we are dating and it is serious and we're getting married, I think is what
And I was like, but you're, but she's, and, but you're, because you, a lot of people kind of linked you guys as brother and sister.
Totally.
Especially Aldo, who secretly was in love with JJ.
Yes.
So he would be like, no, this shouldn't happen.
Right.
He was like, he was the one that was most awkward about it. And he I was like, are you just butthurt because you have feels for Mr. Efficient? And he's all, no, that's ridiculous. And then he'd go,
swoop.
And then he would swooped. Storm out.
Yeah, he,
right,
he,
slam.
He got swooped.
Right.
Classic.
Right. Well, I knew, I mean, he was a good catch, and I wasn't about to let it go.
Yeah, that's,
gay
what,
or
that's
not.
What Aldo thought.
Gay or not, right. I was taking it.
Right, Aldo was on the conversion thing, and he was like probably almost had him like 70%.
He probably
he's
did.
Like, now, who's this? And Mr. Efficient's like, Barbra Streisand. Good. Good. You're doing better. You're doing better.
Doing better.
Right. We're going to see Les Mis.
Yeah. It, yes. It's for art.
Right.
This one on the text line. Anonymous text, you're here. Morning, guys. I still hook up with a coworker every once in a while. Started a few years ago. We were both into each other. Started out as flirting. We both have our families. Whoa. Then one day we just realized all there can be is a secret hookup. From a dark movie theater to my office at work. It sucks Whoa. At times when you want more. Anyways, it works. Happy Friday.
Okay, you know, that is hot because then it's like, oh, I'll meet you by the warehouse and, you know, well, let's go down to the, oh, we'll go get the pizzas.
Yes.
You know what I mean? You become, right. You find little excuses to be like, okay. We'll just drive together. We're coworkers.
Well, I guess I'll go with you.
Right.
Come
see,
on.
Right. Well, I'll give you a ride. I'll see you at the retreat.
Right.
Right. And then you're like, wham, 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 wham. And then you show up all just like, hey, I'm taking notes at the retreat.
And right. Also, right, we just happen to sit together.
Right, exactly. Oh, look, we came in at the same time. That's hilarious.
It's weird. Nothing different.
Right, exactly.
We have more coming in, so please send us your text.
Yeah, and call us, yeah. 303-728-3420. We literally are paying for this phone line.
I don't care what they say about me.
And now.
I go dumb, I go stupid, I get crazy.
Come on and clap.
It's Kathie J's Stupid News.
You know, a lot of us are really particular about our cereal and the quality of our cereal.
Right.
Right?
Like, yeah. Like, in other words, you don't want it to get soggy?
Nah, right.
You don't want to eat it out of the bag either. You want to get the box cereal, the good stuff.
Totally.
Not the cheap bags.
Although, that's not...
When you graduate to the brand names is when you're like, yes!
I really made it.
I did it!
I know, but, I mean, I hate to say this, but... Whatever's in the bags is the same that's in the box. It's almost exactly the same.
No, it's not.
You're just sold on the brand as a kid, no. And you're used to getting that cartoon character and a prize.
No, you could put Tony Tiger Frosted Flakes next to their whatever version of it, and I'll be able to tell you which one is Tony Tiger.
Okay, I believe that, but I mean, I say they're still good enough. We're not buying the box. You're getting the bag. Now pick one out.
Kids would kill
to
for these.
Into that
you are
box
you
cereal.
You could be a good dad. For
yeah.
Sure.
Right. Yeah.
Are you paying for it?
Right.
No.
Well, fine. Here's then why the don't you pay for it with your babysitting money?
I got to tell you, like, those were some of my favorite mornings when you used to send the intern to the store
get
and get like four different cereals and they'd come back. Oh my God.
Gallon of milk.
There was nothing better than that.
It was painful to see how many people stole my idea for the cereal restaurant.
Uh-huh.
But I will say this, like, it's to me a one off. Like, it would be cool to go to a cereal restaurant and have that experience.
Uh-huh.
But once you, like, all of a sudden load it up with your kind of milk, you want coconut milk, you want this cereal, you put some strawberries in it, next thing you know, it's like $8.
Yeah, no,
and
for
you're
sure.
Like, oh my God, I could have bought a bag, two bags of that bag
you
cereal.
You could have, right. Like, you're staring at it in the grocery store going, $4 for a box of my favorite cereal? That's a little excessive.
Right.
But yeah, you'll go below $4 right. For just, because I think it's like $3 for just a bowl of your cereal
right.
At that place. It's right. $8 when you want to make it into a
They're
shake.
They're going to upsell
add,
you.
Right.
They're going to want to say, hey, oh, you don't want
add this
you,
and this.
You want lactose milk or you want
right.
Almond milk or now you throw some strawberries.
What's your favorite cereal, Bolty?
Peanut butter Captain Crunch.
Oh, that's so good.
Or Raisin Bran Crunch. It has like those crunchy yeah. Things in the Raisin Bran.
Oh.
And double scoop raisins.
Mm. I know what you're talking about. You're talking about the raisins that are like rolled in something that are
in
coated?
Dates? I don't think so.
No, they just have like granola in the Raisin Bran. It's
oh, okay.
Raisin Bran Crunch.
Oh,
I don't
okay.
Know what it is, but it's magical.
Yeah, you know what? I would say that I would never buy Raisin Bran, but that was a good cereal.
You know what? And it's having you talk about it, I could go for that.
Right.
I could eat that right
And I
here.
Hate raisins, but it somehow worked.
What is your favorite, Larry?
Oof. gosh. I was,
here we go. Something stupid. He always combines.
No. I like Honey Bunches of Oats. I know that's a regular cereal, but there's once in a while they'll make, and it hasn't been years, but they used to put out like a seasonal Honey Bunches of Pecans.
Oh.
With the green label, and I never see that, but that's my favorite cereal.
Yeah. Oh. So good.
And you?
Oh, Tony Tiger, Frosted Flakes. Yeah.
Have you tried the Tony Tiger with Lucky Charms in them?
No, I don't.
Okay,
need
you
that.
Don't want that.
No,
they're already pretty sugary.
There's right. Cinnamon Frosted Flakes now too.
Yeah, no, I don't need to. I don't need to mess it
you just
up.
Want the classic.
Yeah, you know, sometimes add a banana to it. Oh my God, like it's heaven. Or I put raisins on it.
Okay,
I totally. It's the sweetness I like. So, back to stupid news. A 52-year-old guy named Dwayne from Alabama, he went into the kitchen to get himself some Cap'n Crunch. He'd been thinking about it all day. He was off work. It was time to come in and get your Cap'n Crunch.
And I do love Cap'n Crunch. I like the regular. I like the one with the berries. I like the peanut butter.
I like them all.
Yeah.
Right. Totally.
I like just berries.
You know which is the best cereal? I'm sorry. It's the Reese's. The Reese's Pieces.
Oh, okay.
They're delicious, but they are so, I mean, they're
it's like.
It's
like a dessert.
Yeah.
You're
having worse
dessert.
Than having a whole box of Frosted Flakes.
Right.
I mean,
right,
they're
right,
like
right.
So
you
good.
Feel bad after it.
Oh, so good.
No, no. You feel bad if you put that on, if you pour those on ice cream.
Or that's chocolate
when
milk.
You feel bad.
Right. Yeah. Right. Right. Add the chocolate milk. Yeah.
Right.
Okay. So, anyways, he went to get his Cap'n Crunch and it was stale. His roommate hadn't closed it up right. So, Dwayne started yelling. Rah! You know, I mean, right. Sometimes it just takes one little thing and you snap.
Like you drank the rest of the milk.
Yep, Dwayne snapped. And this is where it gets bad. First of all, Dwayne's missing teeth. So it's hard for him to eat stale cereal. Okay, that's
right,
why
it's
he
extra
doesn't
chewy.
Like it. Exactly.
Right. And then you got to soak it and then now it's all just soggy.
But you think without the teeth to crunch it, it would be painful any other way. But anyways.
I know. And then you're going to have to move it around a lot because he only has teeth on certain sides.
Right.
It's probably funny to see.
Yeah. Right. I know. But he could also possibly choke himself by not chewing certain parts.
So first of all, he's missing his teeth. Okay. Second of all, his roommate maybe should have taken out his dentures and tried the Cap'n Crunch to see what it was like because the roommate was like, it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So anyways, when his roommate wouldn't taste the Cap'n Crunch, Dwayne grabbed an electrical cord and yuck, and smacked him with it.
Sexy.
Yeah. And then he started following him around the house, smacking him
damn.
With it like a towel. Whack, whack, snap, snap. And he called the cops and Dwayne got arrested.
Wow.
Poor Dwayne.
Right. Never got his cereal.
Now, right. Did you get your cereal?
Now it's really stale.
Yeah. And a guy steals stuff from his neighbor and then reports it stolen when they take it back.
Oh, my God. So
wow,
he
this
stole,
is like your neighbor, Bolte.
Yeah, stole his own stuff? Is that what he did?
So, okay. So, 46-year-old guy named Jason from Washington. Okay. So, Jason called the cops Sunday afternoon to report his TV was gone. Cops got there. They figured out what really happened. Jason had broken into his neighbor's place the day before and stolen that TV.
Okay.
Plus, he stole an Xbox and other stuff. Brought it all into his apartment. The neighbor suspected it was him, so she went to his place Sunday morning. His daughter let her in, and she took the TV and the Xbox.
So
and
there's
the stuff
my
back.
Stuff.
It's my stuff. I took it back. So when Jason came home and saw everything was missing,
he saw somebody stole from me.
He had the nerve
to call the police
cops and report the TV that he'd stolen from her the previous day.
Wow. Ooh. And now the cops don't know who to believe.
Yeah, well, he got arrested for residential burglary, theft, and malicious mischief. And he's suing her and the cops for getting it wrong.
Oh, my God. So he's almost like Donald Trump.
Right? Like, you spin
right.
your own story.
Right, you're like, what? Yeah.
Right, that's not it. That's not,
that's not what happened. It was the opposite.
What?
What? It's like the misdirect and the distraction.
Exactly.
And the, right.
Guy,
you know?
You know, and all of a sudden you're like, whatever.
And say it's the other color.
Sure.
No, the sky's blue.
I'm sick of fighting you.
Sky's purple.
You. Fine,
right,
it's purple.
Sky's purple.
Beautiful purple.
Sky's purple.
Yeah.
Oh, it's the most beautiful purple sky I've ever seen.
It's perfect.
Right. Right.
It's perfect. Okay, so finally, police catch a thief thanks to a witness's sketch, and not just any sketch. A hilarious cartoon sketch was able to identify the dude.
So it's like, he saw, I draw characters when people get off the roller coaster at the amusement park. So it was a character?
No, it wasn't even that good of a caricature. It looks like Like a 10th grader would have done it. Like the guy has beady little eyes. Yeah.
Oh my God. Right. Like it almost looks like a
show to Bolte.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me tell you. So this guy stole some cash from a farmer's market last week. Okay.
And then it looks like a 5-year-old drew it.
Right. For real. Totally. It almost like I can
see. Like one of the Snoopy characters.
Right. So, yeah. Right. Little eyes.
Right. Right. Little
one
mouth.
Chin hair.
Big head.
Yes.
Right.
So. There was a witness, thank God, who saw the guy steal the cash from the farmer's market. So that witness offered to draw a sketch of the guy. I got this. Let me just give me a pen and paper. I'll do it.
It was, wow, I didn't know he can draw. This is amazing.
Right. Unfortunately, the witness was terrible at drawing, which you saw the picture.
Right.
Well, it drew, it was just hilarious and everyone was laughing and stuff. And believe it or not, though, one of the detectives saw the sketch and went, I think I actually might know who this is. Based on the sketch.
Girl, he's a Peanuts character. Lives next door to Charlie Brown. Let's go. He's the only black kid on the Peanuts.
Wow, yes.
He went for token.
Right. So the detective put together a photo lineup for the witness to look through. And they were able to identify the guy who the detective thought it might be.
Ugh!
He's a 44-year-old dude named Hung Nguyen. Hung Nguyen. Oh, he doesn't look
hung.
Asian.
He doesn't look hung.
But doesn't he look like a white dude?
Yeah, but he could be biracial. He looks biracial.
Okay, now he's facing misdemeanor charge of theft by unlawful taking. Cops are trying to track him down, but that's hilarious that he got caught.
I would not want that name. That leaves people to believe that you're hung.
Yeah, in New England.
The expectation.
Right.
You're half Asian.
This is going to be weird. Yeah. Right. Surprise me.
Awkward.
Blazin' Hit Radio.
Now with more us.
They're just really funny.
Better music.
Less commercials.
More Larry and Kathy.
So I'm currently sleeping with a couple coworkers, and I'm enjoying it. Yeah.
Okay.
And we have a very small staff here, so I won't be giving names.
Right. Exactly.
Because there's three.
There's two
there's
of
three
us.
Three of us. Four. There's four. Yeah. Four and a half.
Four and a half.
Right.
One, two, three.
Well, I still consider Wiggins one half. Foot in the building.
Okay.
Yeah. Until he fully trains Bolte on some stuff. Mm-hmm. And I told Wiggins, even today, I was like, you should stop by the show and just hang out and give us the update and
right.
sit in the guest chair.
Yes.
And so he was going to let me know. Yeah, he was going to let me know.
Okay. Or at least call.
No, for sure. But right. I'd like to get him in here.
Yeah.
It's been a while since we tickle fighting.
Your fingers are missing
tickle
him.
Tickle fight. Uh-huh. Every time I do it with Bolte, he farts.
That's a smart defense mechanism you have there, Bolte.
Or is that a mating call?
No, I'm just blowing kisses.
You know how whales are all...
You know what? Yesterday I saw a Jimmy John's delivery driver and all I could think of about was you telling me that the owner was naked laying on a dolphin he killed.
Yeah, I'm going to show you that picture.
I was like, it made me look at the driver a little weird. I was like, you're disgusting.
Before we get to the text of if you've had somebody at work and you had a sexual relationship or whatever with them, I was going to say that... damn it, what was I going to say? You threw me off with a naked dolphin picture.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, no, it's all good.
Your fingers miss Wiggins. That's the last thing you were saying.
Oh, no, here's what I was going to say. It's that it's National Pizza Day.
Yes.
And for me, since I converted to stupid plant-based,
yeah.
There are certain things that I do miss. I miss sushi. I miss pizza.
Uh-huh.
And so, like, I could, like, I'm sure I can get my own pizza because I can find my own cheese and buy one of those
cauliflower bases.
Right. Or just even
for the crust.
Right. If I was going crazy, man, you make me sound bad because I was going to buy one of those bubbly pre-made crust.
Okay. All right.
Because they have a thin crust.
And then
And then I could put my fake meat and cheese on it.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
I really
could
make my own.
Yeah, you could.
But there's no restaurant that's that I know of that's like hooking up people like me. So it's like, it's still a slow movement, this plant-based thing. But
yes.
Everywhere, once in a while, you'll see one of those videos online that's like, there's a butcher shop for vegans, or there's a barbecue restaurant in Portland,
right.
Or there's a Mexican restaurant that's all vegan in New Mexico or whatever. Right. So,
because you just don't want to go, you can't go like get a gluten-free pizza and then not add any meat to it.
Well, no, I tried.
Or it's the cheese too.
It's the cheese.
Okay.
And so I went, I was like, screw it. I'm going to eat a piece of pizza.
Yeah.
And Chris bought Papa
Murphy's.
And so like in two bites, my stomach was already punching me from the inside.
Right. What are you doing?
Right.
And we made it so far. Right,
exactly. And so that was completely regretful for like 12 hours. Or I would say 24 hours. My system was jacked.
Oh, see.
So now I have to be very picky if I'm going to cheat in that way.
And that makes me sad to hear, but it's healthier. So
oh, no,
much healthier.
For sure. For sure. Yeah.
Right. Because, you know, I could, Volte and I know, go right now I know. And tear down
smash
a
pizza.
Huge Chicago style pizza.
You know what? You said that the Godfather's pizza was back. That was always a great pizza.
Godfather's is back. Yeah. Because they had it up on 100. They have it. It came to 120th up in Thornton. And
where's
I had
the new
it.
One?
It just wasn't as good. But the new one is down off of Parker Road in Leedsdale.
Okay.
You know where they connect
yeah.
right there?
Oh, that's crazy.
Where it becomes Iliff and,
oh, yeah.
you know,
yeah.
Mississippi. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, no, yeah. I got you.
Yeah, it's right over there. So anyways, back to, you want to do pizza day or the text line?
We're on pizza.
Okay,
so
we're
do
doing
pizza.
Pizza day. So it is National Pizza Day. 1 in 25 people would choose pizza over getting a boyfriend or girlfriend.
Wow.
57% of people say that they love pizza. Yes, I'm in that group. 41% said they wouldn't go as far as to say they love it, but they like it a lot. So more or less, 100% of people like it or love it. There's only 2% of people that hate pizza.
Yeah, that's weird. That's like when you hear somebody go, I don't like ice cream.
Yeah.
You're like, what?
I'm like, you're just trying to be different.
Right.
Okay, because there's no way that that's true.
I have a friend, and I love her. I do love her. But I honestly think that there's things that she doesn't like just because that she's known for not liking
yes,
it now.
I totally know somebody like that.
Like some people like to be like, oh, I don't like this. And then that becomes what they're known for.
Right.
And her thing is, I love you, Karen, but she's all, I love to make desserts, but I don't eat them. So
what?
She doesn't like sweets, but she will make desserts for people.
Okay, well, then that's a good thing, right? That means you just have to be her friend and you get desserts.
Yeah, but then I'm like saying, how do you not know which of your desserts is good if you don't eat them?
That's true. Because
I'll go, did you try this? And she's all, well, I don't eat desserts. And I'm like, but you made it.
Right.
And so it's very confusing.
Yeah. How do you even know if it's exactly how it needs to taste?
Exactly. And if you're not even a fan of it, what are you doing dabbling in that? Why don't you go make some appetizer then?
Go make something that you like.
Right.
That you're going to eat.
That we can eat together.
Yeah. So back to the pizza.
All right.
Oh, the music is
making
me want.
Yeah, this is my Italian dinner music.
Right. It makes me want to go somewhere Italian.
Bolte's got mood music right now.
You know, there used to be an Italian restaurant right over here. It was called Pagliacci's.
Oh, yeah.
It was used to be the best Italian.
And Pasquini's.
Pasquini's is on Broadway.
Didn't they have one over here? Then
no,
I ate at this one over
you're
here.
You're thinking of Pagliacci's.
So good.
Oh, my God.
They have garlic knots.
Insane. Yeah, they closed a long time ago, but it was like literally run by old Italian people.
Oh, so good.
And then that land over there in the Highlands, Lowlands became so valuable. They're like, we're selling this.
Yeah, totally. You know what? We're old.
Right.
We're going to take our Italian food and just eat it in our house.
We got to find out where they live.
3 out of 10 of us eat pizza at least once a week. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's about right.
Definitely.
You don't eat pizza. Like that.
I know. No, I'm sad.
See,
here's what's really sad is, Kathie and I fully bonded over food, so we could actually do entire shows on enchiladas.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or we did a whole week on tacos.
Yeah.
Now that I'm having to adjust, because I can have tacos.
I don't even know who you are.
I can have burgers. I can have so many things, but pizza is one of the ones that just I'd have to go to extra length to make it home, and I don't know why I'm not, because I really do love pizza.
Yeah. 22% of us can eat an entire pizza by ourselves. I mean, if we're talking those little Tostino's pizzas, I mean, come on, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's a given, right?
Even a large thin crust from like Pizza Hut or Domino's,
yeah,
that could go pretty quick.
Yeah, you can do it, but the guilt after.
Right. No,
you're
I know
like,
that's why
there's
you have to,
none left.
I ate that whole thing.
Ditch
I'm
the box.
A pig.
You have to
right,
ditch
hide
the, box.
The evidence.
Yeah.
Our favorite toppings: cheese, number one.
Ooh.
Pepperoni. Ooh. Pepperoni, sausage, mushrooms.
Meat.
Bacon. Mm. Onions, green pepper, black olives, Canadian bacon, and pineapple.
Love onion, love green peppers, love all that.
Yep, and then...
I love some pizzas are great with tomato. I love that whole pizza that's like big pieces of mozzarella.
Oh, yeah.
And then it's like tomatoes and basil.
I love
that's
the way you say mozzarella.
Pizza. Mozzarella.
Yeah, totally. Oh, so good. Oh. Yeah, sometimes a good margarita pizza
is
all I need.
Oh. And it throws everybody off because you're like... Why does this pizza say margarita?
Right.
Because I'm in an Italian restaurant. Right. Why does this drink say margarita? I'm in an Italian
right.
restaurant.
Drink it. Anything in margarita is good.
Oh, yeah. Any other foods we want to talk about?
Yeah, I don't know.
I polished off a whole thing, a pint. That's the size of like a Ben and Jerry's, right?
Yeah, I think that's a pint.
Yeah. Yeah, I polished off a whole thing of the ice cream that's made with coconut milk.
Yeah, but polished but off or started and polished off?
Ate the whole damn thing.
There you go, Larry.
It's so good. Oh, I had it. It's like, almost better than normal ice cream.
Right. It's like salted caramel.
It's crazy. It's,
like, you can't tell the difference now because some ice cream's made with almond milk, some's made with cashew milk.
They're just expensive.
No, for sure. But yeah. I mean, I was home alone.
It was just me. It's just me and my pint.
Right.
All right. Now we're going to the text line. Hear what you had to say about dating coworkers. 303-728-3420. I dated a coworker and we ended up having a kid together. Years later, we ended up separating, unfortunately, but our son is the best and I feel like the luckiest mom. He's my world, Marissa.
Oh, that's nice.
Totally. We love you, Marissa.
No, for sure.
And she's a great mom.
Oh, cool.
Yep. Okay, so this one says, hi, guys. I'll stay anonymous because I'm HR for a well-known place.
Oh, nice.
But I think there's a right place and time for cursing. Oh, we were also talking about swearing at work. Yeah, sleeping with people at work and swearing.
Right. And then if you're sleeping with somebody at work, you're swearing because you're like, yo, blank me.
The HR lady says, some people just don't know when to shut up and not cross the line. I've let go of too many people because of it.
Yeah, because if like all of a sudden HR is really strict at a company, you know, because we used to work at a radio group where arguing was kind of like a thing. Like I remember being in a meeting and it was like, me and the program director were going to meet with this chick from sales that was a total bitch and she wouldn't call anybody back. And, and then it was like the GM was kind of like, almost just brought his popcorn. He was looking like Michael Jackson just in there eating his popcorn, watching this argument go down. And I was like, whoa, this is crazy. And I just
was
remember.
Was I here for that?
Yeah.
I was.
And okay. I remember just being like, knowing there was always a constant rivalry between sales and programming.
Yeah.
Like sales was always going, hey, well, you did this. And then programming was like, well, screw you. You did this.
Right.
And it was constant. And I was like, I always wanted to be like, instead of allowing this to continue, like, the enemy's across the street.
Yeah.
The other radio company.
Not here within us.
Right. Let's not fight here, idiots. Lisa Patrone.
Now, this one says, regarding dating, the same HR ladies texting stuff.
Okay.
It happens, but we have to be ready for negative, everybody. I always see people filing restraining orders for one another while they work in the same schedule. It's too much drama. Don't make us have to deal with that.
Yeah, if you're going to go restraining order, you may as well just go quit that job if you feel that strongly about that person.
Yeah, for real.
Right.
But then it's like, I don't want to quit my job. I like this job.
Well, then learn to get along.
Right, and learn to not.
Right, to bite your
lip.
Learn
to keep it in your pants.
Yeah, for sure. Well, yeah.
You're like, oh, that's too hard of a lesson.
Well, no, I mean, like, the thing is, they're, if you dabble with somebody at work, it can sometimes blow up in your face. There's been a couple that were like, oh, we met and we have kids and now we're happy.
Right.
There's some that were like, it turned into an ugly sexual harassment thing.
Totally. And I had to get a restraining order.
Right,
and they had to change schedule. And
right, for sure.
No, for sure. Okay, this one on the text line says, I've hooked up with tons of girls and work too many to count. And Larry, I know you're gay, but how could you resist Kathy when she was wearing the Muggle shirt? I did love that Muggle shirt.
Because I'm a wizard and she's a Muggle and that's just not allowed.
It doesn't work. It's gross.
Right.
I like Kathy's leather top. She looks super hot in that.
Thanks. Yeah. That's so sweet.
I think that's Kathy's leather special.
I like
what
it.
Does that mean?
Remember Amy Schumer? She wore that same kind of top when she did her leather special here. So every comedian has a leather special. Uh-huh. So that was Kathy's.
It is my leather special.
I like Eddie Murphy's leather special. That was a good one.
When he wore pants and
the red suit or the blue suit with the design in it. Right. You know, I wore the leather special to Black Panther. And I think it had a power over Chadwick Boseman.
Oh, nice.
Because I wasn't aware. Like, I have to go back and watch the. I'm going to watch my interview.
So he came
today.
And peed on me.
No, but he did.
Like a cat.
Yeah. Marked his territory.
But as I was getting comfortable in the chair to do the interview, to start the interview.
The leather went, and you're like, that was the leather. That was not me. That was the leather.
I swear it was the leather.
And then it was like, that was me.
That was me. Oh, everything's recorded.
Oh, my God. Is there a fan in here?
Can you imagine?
Oh, my God.
No, when I sat down, all of a sudden he said, that's a really nice necklace, you know, and it's hanging right where the cleavage of the black leather is and stuff. And I was like, oh, thanks. And people have commented on the necklace before.
Right.
So I'm not thinking anything. I'm just like, oh, some people say it's a bullet or, you know, rape whistle. Right. I don't have cocaine in it, you know. And then I'm still setting up my, you know, to slate to say, you know, like
I'm Kathie from Kathie, Fox 31, Denver.
Yeah. So then I say Kathie J stuff. And he goes, oh, Kathie J, that's a cool name. And I'm still not, you know, like I'm like nervous because I'm not hearing any of it.
You're so focusing on your interview.
I need to go back now today. I'm going to watch to see if
you missed an opportunity to leave your husband.
If I missed an opportunity with Black Panther, I swear to God, I'm going to die.
Yeah, I think he missed that opportunity. He was like trying to be like, let's hang out later.
Kind of. Yeah. You know, like, I don't know. I don't know. And you know what?
I could say like it'd be a question mark, but no offense, but a lot of black guys like you,
yeah,
and they're very attracted to you for whatever reason, and you like them. So I wouldn't doubt that there was something that you missed, and now we're all stuck here in Denver because you missed that dumb opportunity. Hi, Slate, Kathie, there's not cocaine here, it's a necklace. And there went our big moment.
We will play back, you know, through it next week. Okay, and you
word
see.
For word.
Yeah, right.
Pause. This is where he checked out.
Right.
Right.
Because there was a time that producer Annalisa, she got up from interviewing Matt Damon, and he was like, thank you, Annalisa. Thank you. Thank you very much. And one, her name is very hard for people to remember.
Usually a lot of people say, thanks, Annalisa.
Right. Mm-hmm. No, that's you, Larry.
No, I'm saying.
That's how it's spelled.
Right. Annalisa.
No, it's not. I guess
on
it
Craigslist,
is.
It is.
Annalisa. Anyway, they'll just call her Lisa or Anna. They never realize it's one name. Right. So,
thanks, Anna.
So then as she was getting up, he did this, thank you. Thank you very much, Annalisa. And he totally checked her out and like watched her leave the room, and it was all on tape.
Oh my God. So
I just have to go back and see. Maybe I missed this opportunity with Chadwick. And if I did, it's okay because I'm going to find him again in another interview and I will be ready.
Wow. And dumb Annalisa messed up too.
Totally.
She could have been on some ship with him.
Matt Damon. Yes, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Okay. Wow. Anyways. Okay. And one more on the text line. I hooked up with a coworker once. It turned into a relationship that went completely sour, like really, really bad. All in one night, he just turned on me. It was great for 3 years, and then something went so bad. He actually did jail time for it.
Whoa.
Never again, because when he went to jail, people talked so much about what happened at work. And whoa. I worked there.
Right.
Yeah, that's bad.
Whoa, that's crazy. I wonder what he did. Hit us back. I mean, did he do something to her to go to jail, or he just did something because something soured?
You know what? It sounds to me like it's something that involved domestic violence. If a dude's going to jail, I don't mean stereotype.
Right, right. But who knows? You
know, what else?
It could have been, well, if everybody at work knew about it, it could have been like, you know, he's stealing from the company.
Oh, well, no, that wouldn't happen at night.
Oh.
And you have to, yeah.
Yeah, that's when you steal the money. When no one's around.
Expecting it.
Right.
We have more, so keep them coming, everybody.
Yeah, 303-728-3420. Did you dip your pen in company ink?
Blazing Hit Radio.
Good morning, you guys.
Now with more us.
You rock.
Better music, less commercials, more Larry and Kathie.
I just love you both.
Aw, thanks. We love you too.
Yeah.
And I'm sure they love you too, Bolty.
They're getting to love me.
Yeah, producer Bolty.
They're learning to love you, Bolty.
Yeah, warts and all.
Yeah, I'm like that.
I meant genital warts.
That zit you can't reach on your back.
No, you're the zit that you go to scratch your head and you don't know it's in your scalp. And so you're like, ow, what the hell? Or you use a brush on it.
Yeah.
Ah!
I remember once in high school, I was making out with this guy. And
oh, no.
And I ran my fingers through his hair.
Oh.
And I totally capped some zits on his scalp. Oh, it was gross.
I'll be right back.
But it's funny you say that about zits. There's a new toy that just came out, everybody. A toy for kids to use.
That makes you feel like you're popping zits?
It's got a bunch of zits on it. And when you pop them, yellow pus comes out.
Yeah, I've seen it. I saw it on one of those videos on Facebook.
Ugh.
Yeah, and they say it's you can... Because they're all in rows, so you can like pop six at a time one in a row, you know.
And I do like popping pimples, and I hate the fact that JJ, my husband, he is so against it. He's like, don't even try, don't get near me, because he has like a plethora of blackheads going on, and I would love to just get in there and open up the pores, but yeah, he doesn't want me to do it.
When you go get a facial and they do those, that hurts the most, when they get at your blackhead.
It's called extraction.
It hurts.
Ooh.
And then you come out and you're like, looked like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Yeah, you know, what happened?
But, you know, when you see those old guys and they have those crazy open pores on their nose.
Especially like, if they're alcoholics.
The big holes in their nose, that's from them never getting the blackheads out when they were younger and the holes get bigger and bigger.
No, but there's also a condition.
I know, the red nose. Right. Steve Bannon.
Right, for sure, where the pores get just huge.
Yeah. Oh, from alcohol?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
And the whole nose just gets inflamed and it's like has big... The pores like just open up.
It's gross.
That's where you pour the alcohol in. The
yeah,
pores.
Right. And they just go right into your bloodstream.
Right.
But this new toy is called the Poppet Pal. It's a piece of rubber with a bunch of fake pimples on it. And when you squeeze them, the pus squirts out. It runs about $20 at poppetpal.com. And just looking at it right now, I totally would want to try it.
I know,
It includes a bottle of pus, so you can keep refilling it if you want more pus. That's sold separately.
I was told when I was reading it that people were saying that it's not as good as popping a real pimple.
Oh, boo.
Because you just basically squish it, and there's no like...
Ah! Sorry, I just watched it pop out. Yeah, it's good.
But there's no, you know, the hard head.
Yeah.
You know, where you get from the pressure, where it's like the one that gets on the mirror.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, right. You know. Man, I'm sorry. I know it's early. I hope y'all aren't eating when you want to listen. Yes. But my girlfriend, like 2 years ago, it was like a dream come true because she had one on her, the middle of her upper back, and she couldn't get it. And it'd been there a minute. And not only had it been there a minute, I think it was like started as an ingrown hair. So it was something that she was like, could you? And I was like, oh my God, this is exciting. I'd love to. And it didn't look crazy big.
Uh-huh.
And so I just started going on it. And I literally was probably there for like 4 or 5 minutes. And it was all the different parts of what you would love about popping them. Like
Now I'm just going to plug my ears.
Yeah, okay, then we're done. Oh, I won't say anymore.
Right, like, because
But it started out, you know, like, it was just, oh my God, it was
heaven. The hard candy shell.
I mean, it totally, it tied me over, obviously.
Colors of the rainbow.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
The white head's so big that you actually have to grab it with your hand and keep pulling it out. It's like one of those magicians with the scarf that never comes out.
Larry, remember when I got bit by that spider on my side?
Oh, yeah. That was gnarly.
I, like, had to miss work for it. I could flex my waist and make it like ooze.
No way.
Yeah, I swear I could go like, and it would be like.
Yeah, that's when we stopped being friends.
Yeah, we didn't touch for
until
a while.
That was over.
I was like, I cannot be your friend until that goes away.
It was a spider that was on one of the plants or something, wasn't it?
I don't really know exactly what it was, but yeah, I was growing marijuana for a company and it could have been from that. I mean,
my girlfriend got bit in the leg when she was trimming. And so it was on the plants or something, obviously, and it got crazy like yours, the color, the rings of the bruise.
Yeah.
And like it was an infectious bite.
It was one of the more painful things I've ever been through.
It was almost like a make or break deal for our friendship.
Larry's going back to that.
Right, I was like, ooh, that looks like it's getting on my couch.
Oh, can you
sit on this paper?
Don't lean left. Please.
Don't laugh.
I'm all, Yoshi, stop licking it.
Gross.
Kisses for daddy when he gets home.
Gross. Disgusting.
Okay, let's move on then. Let's think about other stuff, like sleeping together.
Yeah. This is somebody slept with their boss.
Yeah, so this one says, yo, yo, yo.
Baby, have you come and give me a kiss?
Used to bone two of my bosses at the same job in the same week.
She's not in the same room at the same time.
Why do you assume it's a girl?
Oh, I don't know. Well, I guess you're right.
Then whoever it was said, to be 20 again with no therapy. Happy Friday. You're absolutely right.
It is a girl. Well, and the thing is, then you risk the two bosses knowing. You know what I mean? Like, because they're probably sharing, like, oh, I'm boning Michelle. He's all, wait a minute, I'm boning Michelle.
You have to text us back, text her, and let us know if it's Mike or Michelle. Are you a guy or a girl?
Right, and were the bosses, did they know about each other?
Eskimo brothers.
Right.
Oh, yes.
Eiffel Tower high fivers.
Yeah.
I hope not. No. This one says, hey, guys, my husband and I met working next to each other in an office setting at Job Corps when I was 19. I flirted with him by throwing a pencil at him and putting a picture of myself on his computer. 10 years later, we're married and we have a baby girl, and we are still working together in the forest industry.
Oh, wow. Cool. That's crazy. Yeah, you throw a pencil at the right person, and there you go.
Good morning show. Was sleeping with a crazy coworker back in the day who had a tramp stamp with the name Blaze. Yes, it said Blaze. He found out like 3 months in and came to our work and waited for me. Was pissed, but all talk. He made her quit, and last I saw of her, she just ended her second marriage. God, I miss that sex. Love you guys.
Okay, so wait, go back to that one. I'm confused on the gender. So, okay, so he's...
I was sleeping with a crazy coworker back in the day who had a tramp stamp with the name Blaze. So I would assume it's a girl.
That's
got to
be a girl, right?
So it's a guy texting, right?
Right, for sure.
So then, yes, that Blaze. Oh, that's what they meant. But yes, that Blaze.
Oh.
Our
okay.
Blaze.
Okay, the guy that we knew.
We know a Blaze. Okay, now let's catch it back up.
Okay.
So it's a girl writing.
Right.
I was sleeping with a coworker back in the day. His name was Blaze. He found out like 3 months in and came... I don't know where the hell. He found out 3 months in, came to our work and waited for me. Was pissed, but I'll talk. He made her quit. And last I saw,
okay, so he's a guy
with Blaze's girl.
Right, exactly.
And she had the tramp stamp
Blaze on the lower back.
Oh, gotcha.
And so he waited for this guy.
Blaze found out 3 months in and came to their job and waited for him. He was pissed. He was all talk.
Right.
He made her quit. And last I saw of her, she just ended her second marriage.
Right. And that he was assaulted by Blaze's breath at the job force. For sure. Definitely.
We love Blaze. I wonder which girl it was. We knew a lot of his girlfriends.
I don't know. He wasn't my BFF.
Oh, he wasn't? Oh,
not really.
Okay. I like Blaze. This one says, I spent $15 for the Tony the Tiger and Lucky Charms. Oh. So it's out there.
Right.
This one agrees. Reese's Pieces are the best cereal, they say.
That is a pretty good cereal, but you almost feel like it's a dessert. It's like, you know, I could have had a piece of chocolate cake.
Right. But, you know, but now I've had this. And now you can't just have one bowl of cereal. I have to have two.
I hate to say this, but you know what really transformed my cereal situation was Chris converted me to coconut milk because when I went plant-based, I just stopped eating cereal.
Yeah.
And then I was like, let me try this coconut milk. And if you put coconut milk in the right chocolate cereal, like I put it with Cocoa Pebbles, it's unbelievable. You have like Almond Joy, the cereal.
Really?
Yes, coconut milk.
So you get, which coconut milk do you get, vanilla or original?
Just regular coconut milk. It's like,
I know, but there's 20 different versions of coconut milk.
I don't know I think ours is unsweetened.
Okay.
So it's just,
boo.
But you can get sweetened, but you know, the Cocoa Pebbles bring enough sweet to it. So when you mix the two together and I chop up bananas in it, it's heaven.
Heaven, I'm in heaven.
Chocolate cereal, coconut milk, and bananas? What?
On the text line, Larry, have you gone to the restaurant Watercourse Foods in Denver? They have good gluten-free and vegan options.
No, but I've heard about Watercourse.
I've been to Watercourse.
Where's that at?
Right on 17th.
Oh, okay.
If it's the one I'm thinking of.
Oh, cool.
It's good.
Yeah, yeah. That's not the one. No, Watercourse. Yeah, I've never
Shannon's
been.
Shannon's taking me there. They have
cool.
Like really yummy pancakes. And
oh, nice.
It's all gluten and vegan-free. And it's pretty
sweet.
Good.
Yeah, I think I'm okay on the gluten, although I wouldn't know a gluten if I saw it. I wouldn't know a gluten if it bit me.
This person wants to know what happened to Wiggins. We will tell you next because I actually have a story that pertains to Wiggins.
Yeah, we'll give you a Wiggins update and on his transition.
Yes, and wait till you hear the story that pertains to him.
Call now.
303-728-3420.
Blazin' Hit Radio.
I'm sorry, I guess I dialed the wrong number.
Call or text now.
Hello?
I know your secret.
Yeah, we do know your secret. Your father owns our invented toaster strudel.
What?
Those are the girls from Mean Girls.
Oh, that's right.
I know your secret.
I'm always like, what? Mean Girls. Love that movie. On the text line, somebody wants to know what happened to Wiggins. They didn't hear...
Wiggins is transitioning. He's going to be Wiggina.
No, he's not.
And Kayla and him will live as two beautiful lesbian women. Well, one beautiful lesbian woman.
Right.
And one not so beautiful. Wig is basically just jumping into fatherhood, and he's all about, you know, making sure everything's cool on his end. So he wanted to get a better paying job. So the guy's completely qualified for a bunch of stuff. He's like... brilliant at so many things. So we just would never hold him back, and we wanted to wish him the best. So we're here for him when that doesn't happen.
Come back,
right? We miss him, and we hope that he's okay. And
yeah, but we talked to him. He's family. We were still in business with him at YOLO, and you know, we're part of his and Kay's life. And the thing is, I told him to come by the show, and I don't know if he's going to come by today, but maybe next week he'll stop by and he'll give us a wig update.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay, so the story I had that related to Wiggins.
Mm-hmm.
How long can you use the same bed sheets before it's gross?
Ooh, you should change them at least once a week, I'd say.
Bolty?
Yeah, I try to. Sometimes I get cold sweats, like when I sleep. If I have a nightmare or something, aww, I'll sweat. So aww, once like a week for sure.
The baby.
That happens when it's like that meme. Have you seen that meme where you put the blankets on you fully, and then you're hot as hell, and then you put one leg out, yes, and then you're frozen,
yes,
and then you put it back in, yes, and now you're hot as hell. Yeah, there's just like a very fine balance between ceiling fan, heat setting.
Yes.
Yeah, it's very like to not get, because if you fall asleep fully covered and you hit sleep hard, you're going to get hot.
Yes.
Yeah, so it's like, it's...
It changes night to night.
You right. know what? And I have yet to find a...
The perfect balance? I'll tell you what it is.
Okay.
Try just the sheet. I know it doesn't seem...
No
I
way.
Know.
No
I,
way.
I know, but try... But I'm telling you...
No, you know what needs to happen is once I fall asleep, someone needs... I need to pay somebody to come in and
move the blanket.
Pull the comforter off so I'm on the sheet. Because okay. I need the weight of something on me.
Right.
I can't just have a light sheet.
She
can't
likes
do
the
it.
Weight like of a Bronco. Yeah.
Doesn't everybody?
Player.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Hey, so, but
what
I
did you think? I meant a horse?
Yeah. Like, what kind She's of not woman into do that, you think Bolte? I am, Bolte?
That's I've disgusting. Seen stuff on the internet.
It's not me, okay? You've seen it.
Now
it's
we
not
know
me.
What Bolte's looking up on the internet.
That's gross, Bolte.
Hashtag horse gagger.
I was talking about a cooling pillow.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I'm one of those people, especially in the summer, I'm flipping my pillow
she
through the
night.
She wants
a cool pillow. A cool pillow.
Okay, so
we have two of those, but I don't use them. They're just like too heavy, and I throw them at Chris.
Okay.
I mean, they weigh like 100 pounds. They have some sort of gel in them.
Yes, I know. Yeah. That's what I. They don't work though.
I don't know. I mean, I kind of just
comfy?
Like the feather pillows, and then of course those get hot. So
yeah. Okay. Well, if you want to, you know, let me borrow one to see if it works.
Well, I don't
do
think
it.
You want my.
Why wouldn't I? You obviously don't use them. You just throw them at each other.
Yeah, but Chris uses them, but he also sleeps like Snow White. Like he's like
you know, he
in
doesn't.
The spell, like with his arms crossed.
Like he's laying so in the glass casket.
We're waiting to be kissed. Right.
He does not, does he?
No.
Okay.
But I do hate him because every time he wakes up, his hair looks cool. Like his hair looks done every time. And like I'll be like, hey, we're going, right? And he's like, I gotta go to the shower. I was like, that's your bedhead? I was like, damn, that looks
be
cool
nice.
Bedhead. Right.
You
I
use
look
the
like
the same products he uses, right?
Right. He just has short, cool, condensed hair. Oh, yeah. I have like flyaway Gianna hair. Like me and Gianna have the same hairdo sometimes.
See? You are the father. So this study, how long can you use the same sheets before it's gross? And I have to say, you know, like in college, you don't have that much money to do the laundry and stuff. So there were definitely times that it went 2-3 weeks. You
right.
know?
If you had had a black light in that room, it would have looked like Avatar. The
no.
whole land.
No.
Like those flowers and the purple dinosaurs.
Maybe in a boy's room.
And it would have just
but
been
not
like,
my room. So the average person says if you go more than a month, that's gross.
That is gross.
So people are willing to tolerate 3 weeks, even 30 days. But if you go past the 35-day mark, you're officially gross.
No, I really think that's not cool. And I understand people that are conservative and they don't want to like waste water and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I get that. But I mean, I think that you should change out your sheets at the very least once every 2 weeks. And I think you should change out your towel that you use from the shower once a week. I
yeah.
mean, if not
right.
more.
I mean, when it smells, that's when you know you got to change the towel.
Wow. That could be a long time. That's 6 months in.
According to a new survey, it also says that America's single population, so this is you, Bolte, the average single person waits 40 days to change their sheets.
That's how long the Jews wandered in the desert.
Oh, yeah.
For 40 days and 40 nights. But wait a minute.
35 days for women, 45 days for single men.
I remember Wiggins.
Yeah,
we
that's
bought,
why,
we bought
that's
him
why
some
I have
sheets.
This story, yeah.
Right, we bought him some sheets to like a little apartment warming when he got his place up by the studio. And in within like a month or two, I went over and I was like, whoa. And these were the sheets we gave him were cream colored, you know, off white.
Okay.
And then I went over and I was like, whoa, you have zebra print sheets. And he's like, no, I don't.
That's gross. That is gross.
Oh, and they were, so they were zebra printed. And I was like, wow, even the
back away slowly cases, from the bedroom.
Right.
Back away slowly.
I'm all, this is, these aren't zebra stripes.
Don't black light that room.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, no.
You don't
want to
see.
That's Avatar 2 and 3.
This is what's funny. Half of us, if we know we're going to get lucky, we put the fresh sheets on before we get lucky. You'd think that you change the sheets after you've gotten
lucky.
No.
People
put the fresh sheets on before you get lucky and then leave them on after.
Right, because you have somebody coming over and you don't want them to see your zebra print sheets.
Well, that's true. Or smell
some weird sheets. So you're trying to be like setting the mood.
That's
Here's some clean bedding for
Look,
us.
This is normal.
Right, and then after we have sex in these sheets, I'm going to leave them on for a couple months.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Right, I can still smell you.
So the overall
average... I might even re-wet him a little bit.
Is 24... Why would you re... Oh, to get the... overall average is 24 days for married couples. So they... Huh. Yeah.
Well, and then it's like some couples are like really adamant about like when they put sheets on, they'll be like, oh, I'm going to shower before I get in my clean sheets.
Yes, right.
Where I'll be like, nope, going to bed, sweaty and farty. Yeah,
right. Take that sheet.
Right. No sheet.
And now.
I know you guys are going to photograph me. I know what makes a cool photo. I got a cool ass car. You know, I'm like, I got a dope ass outfit on. It's all good.
Celebrity Trash and Bash.
With Larry, Kathy, and Wiggins.
Sponsored by the Mike Sawyer Law Firm. Call 303-GOOD-LAW.
Here's Kathy J.
In theaters this weekend, you got the 1517 to Paris, which is about the true story of the guys who took over the ISIS terrorist
The cool thing about that is Clint Eastwood, he directs it.
Yes.
And they held auditions for actors and blah, blah, blah. He went with the three guys that did it.
Yeah.
So they're not actors.
Dudes.
Right. It's crazy.
Yes. And I've heard bad and good about that.
Okay. That like they're kind of not good actors because he picked regular people.
There's that, but also the script is kind of bad.
Well,
yeah.
It's a true story. So, I mean, it's like, to me, if you're like,
I love
it
that.
It looks
stuff.
Scary, right? Mm-hmm.
50 Shades Freed opens today.
Oh my God. You know what? I just don't like her.
Dakota Johnson?
Right.
Is it because of how I told you what a spoiled bitch she was at the interview?
Right. And that Chris Parenti also said that she was like kind of mean.
Yes.
And I understand it because she was born into Hollywood.
Yeah.
Her parents are both rich and they're famous.
And famous.
So I can get how I understand how she got the role.
Yeah.
It was like, oh, hey, can you hook her up or whatever?
And she does have a good body naked.
Okay. I didn't look at that. I never seen the movies. But there's a close up of her face.
Uh huh.
That's a face I can't like.
That's a face.
No. Because the thing is, I purposely went Googled her to try to find pictures that I didn't like of her. And she actually has some where she actually looks all right.
No, for sure. For sure. Yeah. Well, 50 Shades, this is the end. Thank God, everybody. 50 Shades Freed. And Jamie Dornan plays, of course, Christian Grey, the main dude in the movie with Dakota Johnson. And he got asked, you know, why is it, of course, again, the chick, full nudity, front, you know, boobs,
side,
front and back.
Upside down.
Right. And yet we only see your butt and back and everything but your, you know, your junk. Okay.
He's all research shows that people don't like our junk.
He said that he doesn't have anything against going full frontal, but he didn't think the plot really called for it. Really? The plot is about
sex.
That's
ridiculous.
He's
all, I'm a shower, not a grower. I'm a grower, not a shower.
He says, you get to see my butt a lot in the movie, and that really doesn't bother me. You see a lot of Dakota's breasts. I would show my breasts if I had them. Really? So easy for you to say. You don't. I just thought, he says Jamie Dornan, we don't need to be flashing the rest of it. It's not essential to the story.
Whatever. what's confusing to me is they've marketed that movie in two ways. One is to the, sorry, I'm not sorry. Yeah. And it looks fun. And she's like, yeah. And she's driving a car.
I'm marrying the rich guy.
And then some of the trailers are like, intrigue, murder.
Uh-huh.
So you're like, what is it? Is it a fun loving, I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. Or is it somebody gets killed?
It's all of that.
Okay, so is it?
That's the whole relationship. It's up and down. There's the secrets that Christian Grey has.
Well, and then
his in this one, his sister, who's Rita Ora, plays.
Right.
She gets kidnapped.
Okay,
blah,
so
blah, blah.
Well, and then he, like, I saw in the trailer, like, she's hired some woman, and she's like, "You can call me Mrs. Grey." Like, in other words, like, she's trying to,
like,
tell her, like, you're
I'm
not
the wife.
Right, exactly.
Stop trying to sleep with my husband. Because he, in the book, I mean, everyone does want to sleep with him. He's gorgeous and he's a billionaire.
Well, that girl and that actress is way hotter than her.
Yeah, I know,
so
right?
So I can see how he'd want to sleep with her.
He likes Anna because she is Anastasia because she was a virgin when he met her.
She's
and
fugly.
She allows him to do all that stuff.
Right.
Tie you up. Also in theaters today, Peter Rabbit with James Corden, which looks funny.
Yeah, it's a kid movie.
Totally kid movie. Okay, so Jokers, the Joker, such a good role. You only can only played by the best people. Jack Nicholson played the Joker.
Right, Heath Ledger.
Heath Ledger killed it. There's nobody. I didn't mean it like that.
Right, but Jared Leto.
But I think Heath Ledger is the all-time best Joker.
No, for sure. But I like Jared Leto's Joker.
Yes, Jared Leto's Joker was cool. Well, the next Joker could be...
You're a woman.
Joaquin Phoenix. He can play crazy really good.
No, he really is already crazy.
Yeah, so... Yeah. Joaquin Phoenix is in talks to play the Joker in a movie that'll explore the character's origins. It'll be set in the 80s. Being described as a gritty crime drama, the more than a superhero movie.
That's cool.
Now, this is where everybody's getting confused because, you know, Jared Leto is probably still playing the Joker in Suicide Squad 2.
For sure.
And wherever the Joker will show up that
he's supposed to get his own movie with Harlequin.
Yeah, but now it looks like the Joker might be going to Joaquin Phoenix for that standalone movie.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it'll be directed by Todd Phillips, who's known for comedy. So, I don't know.
So, you got, like, cool Jared Leto, kind of hip, still hot.
Yeah.
And then you got, like... Joaquin Phoenix, who's just a great actor.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he'll probably kill it. He gets it.
I know. I'm curious. I would like to. And, you know, he's already got...
Kind of a messed up. He had like a...
His grill.
I think he had like
cleft
a...
Cleft palate. Yes.
And it was always so weird for me to be like, are you sure he's brothers with River Phoenix? Are you sure they're really related?
No, you can tell.
Are you sure? Because it's so sad when one kid gets all the looks in the whole family. And then the other siblings are all,
rah. Yeah.
You call me human?
Yeah.
And the siblings all, ksh, ksh,
ksh. Right. Or worse, they're a little off. They're the B-roll of the main.
Like Hillary Duff and Haley Duff.
Right. Or Brad Pitt's brother.
Oh, right. For sure. You didn't get the right genes.
Yes. Or like, the other Hemsworth brother.
Right. For sure.
Right.
They're like, please don't stand by us.
They're just one off. Like, they're still an attractive man, but they're one off from having that bam,
the
pow.
The it factor.
Yeah.
Right.
So, Harvey Weinstein.
He's the real Joker.
The scandal has now taken a life. Did you hear Rose McGowan's former manager committed suicide?
No.
Okay, so Rose McGowan, of course, one of the originals that Harvey Weinstein had to pay off, and she never worked again in films for a long time, and it really messed with her.
Right.
So this Me Too movement is good for her.
There was a ton of people that didn't believe her, and then there was like, you know...
She got ousted by the industry.
Right.
So, well, her manager... Jill Messick, 50-year-old mother of two, she was her manager when Rose claims she was raped by Weinstein, okay? So she goes way back with Rose.
Mm-hmm.
Well, apparently she committed suicide on Wednesday after battling depression, and in a blistering statement, they said that this all has to do with the Rose McGowan-Weinstein battle. Her family put out a statement saying... Seeing her name in headlines again and again as part of one person's attempt to gain more attention for her personal cause, along with Harvey's desperate attempt to vindicate himself, was devastating, and it broke Jill. She was just starting to get her life back on track, so...
So she was being pulled in both ways. Yes. So she's like, okay, here's the cause, and then here's this guy trying to...
She couldn't handle all the attention.
Right.
And, yeah, that's sad.
Wow, that's sad.
Okay, now let's move on to what we were talking about yesterday. Quincy Jones. Man, he doesn't give a mother blank about what he's saying. He's 85 and he's making sure everybody knows his truth.
Right. He's spilling all the tea on everybody. It was like, it's almost like he can't stop himself.
Right. Like you ask him about anything.
I'm like, Richard Pryor had sex with Marlon Brando.
That's what I want to talk about.
Right. And it's like, I saw a clip that they had. Richard Pryor was at a roast.
Okay.
And he's standing there and he's talking and there's a guy next to him.
Okay.
And it's another African-American man and they obviously know each other.
Okay.
And so Richard Pryor's
another
like,
actor?
I don't know. Okay. I don't recognize
okay.
him.
Okay.
But Richard Pryor's like, oh, this guy thinks he's got something on me. He's like, I don't care. He's like, I'll say it. I blanked a dude. And he's like, and I liked it. He's like, I'd blank him again. And then you could tell that the guy next to him is laughing his head off because he can't believe Richard Pryor's telling
saying
everybody
it.
This.
Right.
And the whole room's laughing because they think Richard Pryor's just being funny.
Oh, my
and
God.
So, right, but it turns out, like, more than a couple times, Richard Pryor was fairly open about his love of man love.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, so there you have it.
Right, and his wife, she was like, yeah, he's down.
That's what I want to talk about.
Right.
So, Richard Pryor's widow talks about his bisexual experiences. Turns out, she said, Jennifer, the widow Jennifer, says Richard has sex with plenty of guys back in the day, but he wouldn't call himself bisexual.
She thought he was bi, a widow bit.
By a widow bit.
A widow bit.
So Richard Pryor's widow Jennifer says, quote, instead of putting labels on it, Richard just saw himself as a sexualized creature who wasn't afraid of exploration and experimentation. In the 70s, everybody was doing that.
Huh.
Last October, Jennifer is publishing Richard's diaries in which she says he talked about his sexuality in a very nuanced and profound way. Jennifer says that Richard Pryor was dyslexic and would often spell things phonetically, and the diaries will be published exactly as he wrote them, so you really get inside his head.
Right, dyslexic. So he's like, I went for a vajayjay, ended up with
a penis.
Yeah, right. I just got it mixed up. I'm sorry, I'm dyslexic. Mm-hmm. I'm dyslexic.
That's not a word.
It is now.
Meanwhile, Richard Pryor's daughter, Rain Pryor, unloaded a pair of messages on Facebook. Not only is she denying that her father had sex with Marlon Brando, she also said Quincy Jones, who started that rumor, is losing his mind.
I could see that.
And then she claims that Quincy and Jennifer both hated Richard, and that's why they are totally doing a smear campaign against her father.
What's crazy is, like, I mean, I don't know if, you know, Richard Pryor was into that or whatever, but I mean, it's like, it sucks that he's not here to, like, be able to say.
See, exactly, because he would be honest.
Right.
But it obviously, he was honest. You just saw a clip of
right,
him being
of him saying it.
I blanked a dude.
Right.
I'd do it again.
Oh, we've all done it once.
No.
Oh, no?
I mean, I've done it once.
Right.
Bolte, have you done it once?
Nope.
Okay, see? We all haven't done it once, Larry.
Way to put him on the spot. I mean, now the guy can't even be honest.
Call or text us now.
I'm so excited.
On the YOLO Rum phone line.
Alexa, will you be my friend?
Of course we can be friends.
303-728-3420.
You seem very nice.
By the way, if you go to 31 Flavors today, you get a free sample of their sweetheart pie.
Ooh.
Yeah, but I think that's probably a small little sliver.
Oh.
They're just trying to trick you into buying one.
Yeah, because while you're there, you're definitely going to... Well, as long as I'm here, I'll have a scoop.
You know what they have now is those scoop of ice cream served in between two warm cookies?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I've ever tasted anything better than that.
Yeah, you went and got that.
Those are incredible. Like, they really did get the next thing to me. Like, two warm cookies of your choice, a chocolate chip and a chocolate cookie.
Yeah.
And then a scoop
and
of vanilla.
And then your scoop of ice cream.
Right, whatever. Oh, my God.
No, I agree.
That's pretty dirty.
Baskin-Robbins is great. I couldn't tell you the last time I went.
Right,
because it's
sure.
expensive for that little small amount of ice cream they give you.
I know.
Even though it's bomb.
Right. No, I hear you.
And, all right.
Yeah.
Well, so, okay. So, do you want to do the text line or do you want to...
Do we have a shout out? Somebody sent us a shout out, so we can do that first.
Yay, and it's Friday.
Yeah, all you got to do is on your app, on our app, go to your menu and there's a shout out button. You can pre-record it and then hit send, and that's exactly what this person did.
Good morning, Larry, Kathy J, and producer Bolte. I just wanted to call and let you guys know you guys are all killing it, but Bolte, you are doing a fantastic job. You have the sweetest, most kind voice, and you always sound so happy and upbeat. We will miss Wiggins dearly, but we are so happy to be listening to you, Mr. Producer Bolte, and continue up the good work. Thank you so much, guys, for making us laugh.
She's right. You have a very soft, warm, sensitive female voice.
You should catch me on the weekends.
Oh, yes. No. What does your voice become on the weekends?
Fist bump.
It gets higher. It gets higher.
What's funny is... But we worked with Wiggins for a long time, and he's always been the cranky one.
Yes.
For the most part, the one that's most mad about getting up early.
Yes.
And we got used to it, so whatever.
Yeah.
So over the years, we got used to his crankiness.
Yes.
We kind of accepted it.
Right.
And then toward the very end, he was like really cranky. So it was like, you know, people were like, oh my God. That's why Bolte shines so brightly.
Right.
Because in comparison, Bolte's like, good morning, everybody.
Right.
I'm here.
Oh my God. He said good morning, and it sounded like he was smiling.
But here's the difference. Wiggins had been in this business long enough to become jaded.
Yeah.
So just understand this. We will jade Bolte.
Yeah, I'm still fresh meat.
Right. We're a couple years away, and then you're going to be like, who's that a-hole that answered the phone that's all mad that the sound effect didn't play, right?
You know what? I think that's one of the reasons why I got my first full-time job in morning in the morning radio because
the girl that we were working with was jaded.
She was so cranky. Like, I remember
negative.
Like even when you were off the air, I heard people always saying that she would always be in a bad mood.
Right. So even within the building.
I came in smiling and just happy, and people were like, oh my God, can you stick around more? It's just nice to have somebody that's happy in a good mood. It gets old when somebody's always negative.
Hello. When Kathie came bouncing in, she was like giggles and jugs.
Yeah.
So everybody was like, hire her.
Yeah, we like her.
Right.
To keep her.
Yeah.
But even though I'm jaded, I'm still always more or less in a good mood.
We're not jaded. We're always having, you can be jaded. but the thing is, for doing this for so long, yes. We are still so having so much fun doing what we do.
Exactly.
And it really is because of all the people that text in and, that call in and that stay in touch with us on our social media. You're the reason that we continue to do this because you're so happy we're back. How could we let you down?
Yeah. Right.
You know what I mean?
I'm so lucky.
You made us Denver's number one show for 15 years. We're not going to turn our back on you.
Yeah, and look at how lucky I am to work with Denver's number one morning show. Like, I feel blessed. Like, I'm super stoked to be here with you guys, and every day's awesome.
See? Not jaded. Wiggins, fully jaded.
Yeah. I remember the first time Bolte called in as a listener.
Oh, yeah.
You were with another guy.
Max.
And you guys were drunk.
Oh, my God.
It was early in the morning. And you guys had been up all night and you wanted to talk to us.
And they wanted to be on the air. And,
yeah.
Yeah.
And you guys were hilarious.
Yeah. They were like, you guys did something in Colorado Springs. You drove around in a truck.
Yeah.
You...
We worked for the water department in actually Woodland Park, Colorado. And somehow KS came through like crystal clear.
Uh-huh.
So we wanted you guys to know that we were all the way up in the mountains, and Larry took it to two guys hanging out in the mountains.
They were two men alone in a truck.
Nah, Larry.
Well, yeah. And then after I met them, because I met you guys not long after that.
Yeah, a week later, we were coming up the Elitches, and we met up. And
yeah, and I was like, whoa, Max was the one. I was like, move, weird Mike Bolte person.
He's a nice guy. Get
right,
out of here.
I'm going to move out of the way. Tell me more, Max. is Max your full name? Is it Maximilian? What is it? And I definitely was like, had a Max thing.
Did I ever meet Max? I don't think I ever did.
No.
Okay. No. And then Max made a huge mistake early in our friendship.
What?
By divulging that he was super endowed. Because then I was like,
oh, God,
I know, but I mean,
oh, my God.
I know, it was his fault.
It was his fault. And then
don't lead into this.
No, I'm just saying forevermore, then I was like, Max. Okay. Woohoo!
Do you still talk to Max?
Yeah, for sure. I saw him a couple weeks ago. We went to an Avs game. He's the same kid, but now he's all in the gym. You got to see him now.
He's all shredded?
Yeah, he's chopped up.
Whoa, I need to...
Does he have an Instagram account?
Yeah, we'll look him up.
Okay, let's look him up.
Yeah, we got to get him some yoga pants.
No. Okay, on the text line, people are still giving their experiences dating a coworker.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me, this one says, I once dated... I totally burped in y'all's ear. I'm sorry.
Excuse me. It's quiet.
You do it all the time, and I don't think you should apologize for it. I think we all expect it now. Kathie eats a big calzone every morning with a big thing of beer.
Meat lovers.
And then so it's like when she's not talking, that's going down. Uh-huh. So then when the mics go up, it's all...
Excuse me.
Sausage.
That was going to take a while. Larry.
That was you.
No, it wasn't. Anyways, back to the text.
She's outraged
line.
When I bring up endowed men and burp. She's like, Larry!
I once dated a supervisor in secret off and on for over a year. It was terrible. I was 21, so I didn't know well enough at the time to break it off earlier. He was 30. I swear this man has schizophrenia. He thought he was destined to be the next Messiah and told me that a secret society tried on at least three occasions to recruit him. I asked for proof of said letters, but he wanted to protect me from him and refused to show me. On top of that, he was insecure, which made him jealous when any guy talked to me at work, and me being 21, that was often. When the conversation was strictly business related, he would still get upset. Had to quit because he made my work life a living hell.
Yeah, I would say stay away from anybody that thinks they're special.
I'm going to be a messiah.
Right,
yeah,
for sure.
Totally.
That's how cults get started.
Yes, totally. Someone agrees with you, Larry. Cocoa Pebbles and coconut milk is the bomb.
You could slice up some banana in it. It'll transform your whole life. I posted that on Instagram, and so many people were like, I tried it. It was amazing.
You know what? I could try it this weekend.
Yeah, cocoa pebbles. Coconut milk to your liking,
mm-hmm.
and then chopped up banana. And I swear to God, I'll be the first phone call you make after you eat
it. Okay, all right. Let's see. This one says, okay, I have a question. Are you guys on until 10? You were talking about something the other day at 9:30, and I don't know if I could text you if you were there or if it was the repeat. Educate me so I know when you guys are actually live.
We are out of here at 10. So Kathy leaves a few minutes early. We put in a couple breaks, but Bolte and I are here, and we're still doing our thing. So the show ends at 10 and starts to repeat from the beginning at 6 a.m.
Right. So 6 to 10 a.m., we're here.
And keep texting because we'll use them tomorrow or Monday.
For sure. And if you use your shout out on the app, definitely shout us out because we'll play them back.
Yeah, we need those.
You heard that. Bolte got like a little excited. That lady was super sweet.
That was really nice. Tell everybody what you said, Bolte.
She sounded real hot.
That's what he said when he was editing it. He was like, she sounds hot.
For those first 6 months that I knew him, Mike Bolte, his name was to me, Not Max. I'm like, hey, Not Max. Is Max around?
Pet me. Move aside. Pet me.
So Max isn't coming then. So then I'll just see you guys next weekend.